Hey guys, welcome back to architutors and this Grasshopper Rhino tutorial on parametric design. In this video, we will see how to design a parametric furniture using a Grasshopper script, but you can use the definition to create some other parametric designs or parametric facade as well. First, I'm going to set up a curve in Rhino using the curvy command. Ever wondered how to curve your enthusiasm? Ask a parametric pro. Anyway, let's start Grasshopper. Insert curve component and right-click and set one curve. Select the curve we created in Rhino and hit enter. This will be the base curve around which our parametric geometry will take place. Enter the component move to create a copy of the curve along any axis. Enter number slider for the distance value and insert Z-axis component. Now to divide the curve into a number of segments, we can use divide curve component. Do it for both the curves. Add shift list component. To create connections between points from both the curves, insert line component. We can manipulate these connections by changing the value on number sliders. In parametric design, algorithms are like recipes. Just add a pinch of creativity and a dash of logic. Now let's also divide these line connections into segments where we will define curves. Add flip matrix component and insert interpolate curve to establish curves. Make the closed loops for the curves. These curves change as we change the connections and points we established. To create surface out of these curves, enter boundary surfaces component. Insert extrude to extrude the geometry or surfaces we just created. Enter Z-axis component to do it along Z-axis and define thickness. Enter custom preview to see the preview of the geometry. And enter pipe to make the line connections into pipe geometry and define its radius. You can move the curve in Rhino to have different results and of course manipulate the number sliders. Generative design is like having a magic wand, just wave it, and voila, shapes appear. And last, we can bake the geometry into Rhino. That's how you can create a Grasshopper definition for such parametric design in Grasshopper and Rhino. You can check out more such tutorials on our channel, so make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon for all the updates. Happy parametric designing! See you next time!